Best truly wireless earphones on a budget? Let's get started. Hey guys, this is Sharan here from 24/7techie, and in this video we will be comparing Redmi Earbuds S with the Realme Earbuds Neo. I think that's the name. So yeah, names are confusing, but overall the products are good. This is 3000 rupees, this is 1800 rupees, and we will be comparing these two. Yes, the price difference is around 40%, that's a huge, but I don't have a better competitor to Realme Earbuds Neo. Yeah, let's get started. But before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our further videos. Now that you have done that, let's compare these two. So let's start off with the design of these two earphones. So Realme has went with Apple AirPods clone or Apple AirPods design, and Redmi has went with in-ear design, a very good looking in-ear, a very small in-ear design. But I prefer the Redmi ones because these do not fit in my ear very well, so it comes out very quickly. But this one fits much better, and I really prefer this one. Realme ones, the over-the-ear ones, are not suited for me. So like this, it comes out very easily. Yeah, but it's a personal thing, because I have a friend who only uses these. He loves his Apple AirPods, and he says that his ear aches with this one. So it depends on you, but for me, Apple AirPods design isn't really good. This one is the best. In-ear, small, good looking. Let's move on. So before talking about music quality, we will first have to talk about drivers. Realme ones comes with a 13mm drivers, whereas the Redmi ones comes with a 7.2mm drivers. Almost twice the difference. But that difference doesn't matter, size doesn't matter, because this one is fully in-ear and this one is semi-in-ear, so it is much closer to the ear or eardrum, and that makes it almost same design, almost same size. So this one is over the ear, sort of semi-in-ear, so this one is over here, which this one is goes completely in-ear. So this one performs almost as same level as this one. And now when we talk about music quality on both this one are pretty similar. Bass is better on this one, a little bit better punchier bass, but this one has better vocals, this one has better sound separation, instrument separation, and is a little bit louder on top volume. But overall it's very close, it's around 80. If this one gets 20 points, it will get 18 points at maximum. That's the only difference. This one is good if you're not a bass head, this one is better if you're a bass head. Now that we are indoor most of the time, we are making a lot more phone calls that we used to, and we will have to test out call quality on this. So here is a sample.
So guys, this is the audio sample from the Redmi Earbuds S, and I am in my room where the air conditioning and the fan is switched on. So guys, this audio sample is from Realme Buds Air Neo. I'm still in same place. The air conditioning and the fan is on. It's quite noisy.
So with those sample, it is pretty clear that Realme ones are good, because the mic is over here and it's much more closer to the mouth compared to Redmi ones, where the mic is over here and this one is over here. So the mic is far away from the mouth, and that also shows in the audio quality or call quality. So now when we talk about controlling the earphones, Realme has it better on paper. So touchpad controls compared to Redmi, where it is a button. So yeah, it is supposedly better, because button you have to press hard compared to a touchpad, but this touchpad does not work 100%. Let me show you. So now that we are talking about the touchpad controls, I will show you that it works sometimes, but it doesn't work most of the times. Like double tap, it is working very slow right now, or it's not working. So long press for Google Assistant, and nothing. It is not working, and I have enabled it. So I have enabled it. So long press for voice assistant is enabled, but it is not working. So most of the time things are not working like this. So now when we compare it to Redmi Earbuds S, first of all, these earphones does not have any app like Realme Link where you can customize the buttons, and second of all, there are not a lot of functionality. So you cannot change music, So no matter what you press, no matter what you do, you cannot change music by the buttons. You will have to call Google Assistant to change music. So we can call Google Assistant like this. Next track. And as we can see, it has changed to next track, but it will only be done through Google Assistant. Play pause works very well. It is much more responsive. And every time when you press the button, you have a haptic feedback and you know that you have been successfully pressed the button.
So when we talk about battery performance, the battery performance on these two are okay. So both of them will last you between 3 to 4 hours, and that's okay. Not really very good, not bad. And the case will actually help you in getting a lot more battery. So the Redmi case can charge the earphones twice completely, whereas the Realme ones can charge them 4 times. The Realme case has 400 mAh battery, whereas the Redmi ones has 300 mAh battery. So Realme has done a very good job in adding 100 mAh battery in almost the same footprint as the Redmi ones. So the weight of the case and the earphones are pretty identical, so it's a very good job done by Realme on adding that 100 mAh battery in these cases. So audio latency, let's talk number. Realme claims 119.2 milliseconds of audio latency, whereas the Redmi claims 122 milliseconds of audio latency. In my opinion, that's not a huge number. I do not notice any difference.
So guys, this is the audio latency app. And as you can see, I have kept the mic very close to the earphone so that you can also hear what I was able to test out. So first thing what I will do is connect both the earphones to the phone and play. Stop. I will clap so that you know that the audio is synced and I have not fooled around with this. We will change earphones now. So now we will test out the Realme Buds Air Neo. I will clap to sync audio so that you know it's synced, and we will start.
So after my testing, the results were that the claims of 119 and 122 were pretty close when you are using single earphones. So the other ones are inside the case, not connected to either of the case or to the phone, then the audio latency is around 100 and 120 milliseconds. But when you compare the two together, either these two together or these two together, then the audio latency actually goes around 200. So there is a little bit extra latency when you connect these two and you are using both of them. Then the earphones have to separate the audio or whatever they have to do. So the audio latency actually increases to around 200 or 220 milliseconds. But I do not notice any difference when you say 100 milliseconds difference or 200 milliseconds difference. I played a lot of games on PUBG with these two in my ear, with these two in my ear, with this in my ear, or with this in my ear. I did not notice any difference. So if you are a guy who notices difference of 100 milliseconds, then either play it on speaker because there is no latency, or play it via earphones because there is no latency in wired earphones. But if you are playing with a truly wireless earphones, then you will get audio latency of at least 120 milliseconds. I guess you should accept 200 milliseconds, but if you are using only one, which I usually do, I play games like this, which is 119 to 122 milliseconds of audio latency. You should accept that and move on, because I don't think there is a difference or an upgrade coming up soon. So some FAQs. Both of the earphones do not have wear detection, so there is no proximity sensor on any of them. So there is no wear detection or there is no play pause like this. So another question that I really got was that how is the pairing? Pairing is very good. But I have an issue with pairing, and that is that these earphones, the Realme ones, will pair immediately. So the moment you open the case, it's paired. It will not wait for you to take out the earphones. It will not wait for you to take out this earphone. It's paired
the moment you open it. It can be a positive and negative. So positive, because you don't have to wait for the earphones to connect, as it's already connected. It takes you a couple of seconds, 4-5 seconds from opening it and taking it out and putting it in your ear. So it's already done everything. You just have to resume the music or play music. But it's also a negative. When you are using something else or some other Bluetooth device, you take this out of your pocket and this happens. Everything goes here and you miss out on music or something or other. But when you say this one, so what they do is, so this thing does not have any functionality. So the moment you open it, it will be red if it's charging. If it's there's no light, then it's completely charged. That's a positive, because they do not have any lights over here. And you take it out, it's paired and it's pairing. So you do hear a feedback when it's paired. Your tongue is a thing that you will hear. So this was my full comparison of these two earphones, Redmi Earbuds S and the Realme Earbuds Neo. Name needs to improve. But overall, these are very good. But I will recommend Redmi because of the price and performance, 1800 rupees, and the design. Amazing. Yes, it could have been cheaper. It is very cheap in China when you compare it to India. But what can we do? They are importing it, a lot of custom duty, a lot of taxes, everything. So I will not blame Xiaomi for pricing it at 1800 rupees. They've done a very good job. Yes, it's cheap in China, but it's also very good price for Indian users. Now when we talk about this one is expensive. This one is a little bit better build quality compared to this one, yes, but these could have been priced at 2000 rupees and then it would have blown this away in a lot of other scenarios as well. But priced at 3000 rupees, I will not recommend it. You should either go for the 4000 rupees variant of this, because you will get USB-C, you will get wireless charging, and you will get wear detection. But this one is a waste. If it would have been priced at 2000 rupees, then it would have been amazing. But priced at 3000 rupees, no, I cannot recommend this to anyone. I will recommend this, either go for this one, 1800 rupees, or go for 4000 rupees one, the Earbuds normal, which is much bigger upgrade. So guys, don't forget to hit that like button if you haven't already. I do think it was a good video. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Please guys, subscribe. That would be a big help. Comment below on which one would you go for. And do you agree with my conclusion of Redmi being better? I think you would agree. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you in my next one. Till then, see ya. Thank you very much guys.